Continuing on with this concept of methods, I wanted to kind of hit a couple more points. One is that instead of passing in a specific number and having this hard-coded into the program, we can set up and have the user enter a number. And so I'm going to set up import the java.util.scanner, and then I'll set up that scanner. Whoops. Scanner in equals new scanner system in. Okay, so now I can read in data. And then I'm going to have the variable for the squared number, which is the result. And then I'm going to have the variable for the number and set it equal to 0 to begin with. And then I'll ask the user. I'll say system.out.println. Which number would you like squared? Okay, and then I'm going to read in that input. So I'm going to say number is equal to in.next. What type? Well, it's an int, so next int. Okay, so now when I call this method, the square method, I'm going to pass to it the integer which the user has entered, rather than, again, me putting a specific number in there. If I do this, then it will ask, which number would you like to be squared? And then I can say 10, and the program works the same as it did. It'll give me 100 as a result. So I don't need to pass in a specific number like 10. I can instead pass in a variable, and the variable is just interpreted what is out there at that variable. Now, notice that I named it number here, and I named it number here. But these two variables are separate variables in memory. Again, when we do our little drawing here and of memory, there's a variable here and there's a variable here that have been created when we do this. One variable belongs to the main method. So this is the main somebody please get me a pen board number. Okay, this is the main number, so that's a dot there, main number, and this over here is the square dot number. Two completely separate variables in memory, but when I do this method. Now I say, which number would you like squared? And let's say I enter a 5. That's what's sitting out in that variable when I pass it in. At the time we hit this int number in the method declaration, when the method is called, then a new integer is created called number for the square method. And what goes into it is a 5 as well. Okay, and then it runs the calculation based on that. But what if up here I named it something other than number? What if I named it blah? Okay, very descriptive. And then here I pass in my blah number. Well, the program should work the same. Whoops, except for I gotta set it here. The program should work the same. Which number is going to be squared? 10 and 100. It doesn't matter. It's just like, you know, a pen. I'm holding here a pen in my hand, and we call it a pen here. If I were to take this and hand it to somebody who speaks Spanish, they would call it a caneta, right? Is that Spanish or Portuguese? I don't know. Whatever it is, I'm pretty sure it's a caneta. Isn't that? Maybe it's Portuguese. I speak Portuguese and know a little Spanish, and so I might be getting things mixed up, but it doesn't change the fact that this pen is this pen, that we call it two different things. It doesn't matter. It's the same information. So I take and pass in my variable, which is called blah, which holds a 5, and a new variable is created in memory that's an integer called number. So this is a definition, just like we have a definition here. This method is defined in memory, and then that information is stored there, if that makes sense. So that's one thing that I wanted to make sure that we understand. The other thing is that we don't have to set this equal to a variable. We can actually call the square.blah method in the print statement. Now maybe I've messed everybody up by saying blah. Let me put this back to number because that makes more sense. It's more descriptive, right, of what's going in. So instead of calling the square blah number, I call square and then pass it the number that I've gotten from the user. And I do this inside the print statement. Now if I run this method and say I would like to have 10 squared, then I get the 100 back. How did that print that? Well, it was returned in the middle of a print statement. And what this reminds me of, now many of you are probably not old enough, but some of you will be, to remember a show called Quantum Leap. This was a very popular show where this guy from the future, he was trying to leap to another time, but then something went haywire and he leaps from kind of body to body to body, solving problems. It was actually a pretty clever concept. I think it's on Netflix if you want to look it up. Anyway, he would always drop into the middle of a situation. That was always the beginning of the show, is he's leapt from his previous body, whatever it is, and he leaps into a new body, and he doesn't know who he is, he doesn't know where he is, he doesn't know what year it is, he doesn't know anything, because he's leaping through time, hoping someday that his next leap will be the leap back home. Wasn't that the thing? So he leaps through time, and all of a sudden he drops in, and he's in somebody's body, and he's got to try and figure out who he is, where he is, what year it is, and what he's supposed to be doing to solve whatever problem this person has in their life before he leaps to the next body. And that was a pretty entertaining show at the time. So that's what's happening here, is when we return the result, it gets returned to whatever we're doing. And because we called square and passed it the number, the square method, and we passed it the number in the middle of a print statement, this 100 is dropped right back out through this portal into the middle of the print statement, and so it just prints. And so I could even say something like the result is, and then concatenate on, if I would type right, the result is, and then concatenate on the square number. So now if I square this, so which number would you like to be squared? 15. The result is 225. And what's happening is it starts to print out the result is, and then it sees, okay, I got to call this other method. So let me jump down to that method, and I'm going to pass to it whatever's in the number variable, which happened to be a 15. So on this end, it sets up a variable called number, and it drops a 15 into it because that was passed in when this method was called. It says, okay, now go in and declare another variable called result, and then reset the result equal to the number times the number. Okay, so 15 times 15 gives us 225. Drop that back into the result variable, and then return the result variable. Well, it pops out in the middle of this print statement and just becomes part of it as it's printed. This, in essence, almost becomes like a variable, right? And that's why when we declare methods, always declare it with a lowercase letter, because of situations like this. It's almost like a variable, right? And that's the convention that we use. Okay, so that's a little more information on methods that hopefully is helping to understand what's going on with methods. Like I said, in any given program, you might have hundreds of different methods that do different things, that perform different functions. And what was the result? Now I don't need to go to all the trouble to type in 2 times 2. I can just call the square method and pass it a number, and now my laziness has paid off, because once I have this method written, now if I need to use it later on down in the program, let's say I'm 100 lines down in my program and I need to square another number, I just call that square method again, I pass it a number, and then it returns me a number, which is the result. All right? Okay, hopefully this is making sense. Spencer, leaping.